Matt, and welcome to M.R.E. Tutorials, the show where we show you how to make movie props. Today, to kick off the very first episode, is a dedication to all those Doctor Who fans out there just like me. And today, we're building a sonic screwdriver. A 3/4 inch by 3 inch chrome nipple, and please, no comments about the name. A 1/2 inch by 1/4 inch pipe bushing. A 1 inch to 3/4 inch reducer. A 1 inch by 1/2 inch brass coupling. A 1/2 inch flare nut. A 1/8 inch by 1.5 inch brass nipple. A 3/4 inch to 1/4 inch brass bushing. A 5 millimeter high brightness ultraviolet LED. An LED housing, a small momentary switch, 4 small neodymium magnets, 3 button cell batteries, a soldering iron with solder, of course, miscellaneous electrical wire, a drill, a hot glue gun, and wire cutters and wire strippers. The first step is to assemble all your pipe fittings according to your design. This is what my design turned out to be. Now, you need to drill a hole where you want the button to be. Be sure this hole is big enough for the button to fit through. Now, put the LED in the LED housing. Next, you need to assemble your battery pack. Put the 3 button cell batteries together and put 2 magnets on each end, the positive and negative end. You should get something that looks a little bit like this. Now you're going to want to place the LED assembly into the front or emitter section of the sonic screwdriver. Now when you're hot gluing this down, be sure you do not hot glue over the inner threads. Next, we're going to attach some wire to the connectors on the LEDs. Be sure you have your polarities right. I recommend using color-coded wire. I used red for positive and black for negative. This helps a lot later when you have to wire up a switch and the batteries. This next step is not necessary, but I recommend doing this if you are going to twist up the wires. Add heat shrink tubing onto the 2 open connections to make sure that they don't touch. Now, you could just not twist this, or you could just use electrical tape instead of heat shrink tubing. Now, place this part back on the sonic screwdriver and tighten it down. Then unscrew the front section and wire up your switch. Instead of telling you how to wire up a switch with the LED, I'm just going to show you a simple diagram. The reason we're using 2 neodymium magnets on each side of the battery pack is because the wires will be sandwiched in between them. The positive wire will be sandwiched in between the 2 magnets on the positive side of the battery, and so will the negative one, except the negative one will be on the negative side of the battery. When I tried to align the switch with the hole I had drilled earlier, I discovered it was too small, so I recommend drilling the hole a little bit larger than you think it should be, so you know the switch will fit and you know it won't get stuck. Now, tape up your battery pack if you need to, and hot glue your switch down, and you're just about done. Make sure that your battery pack is small enough to fit into the main body of the sonic screwdriver. Also, make sure that it can freely move in there, so it won't get twisted and break up your wires when you screw the thing back on. The next step is final assembly, and once you're done with this, well, you're done.
Now, with this build, the main thing I didn't mention in the list of parts is something you'll need a lot. Creativity. Don't follow my design. Make your own design. Sure, you can use the wiring design I used, but create your own sonic screwdriver design. Don't copy me at all. You know, create your own design. Use your own colored LED. You could use a green one in here. That's what I was originally gonna do. Except the green LED kinda got broken. But, you know, I'm not gonna go into that. So be creative, and have fun, and also, be safe.